One of the most powerful verses in the Quran about dua is وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord has said, He has announced, make dua and I will respond to you. This is a clausal condition. In Arabic we call a الشرط وجوابه. You have a condition, if you make dua, then I will respond to you. What this means is very simple. Every single dua will be responded to by Allah. And this is something that is explicitly mentioned in the hadith. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no servant of Allah that makes dua except that Allah will give him what he wants, or will give him something equivalent, or will avert a calamity away. One of three things. You make dua, oh Allah, I want this job. Oh Allah, I want to be rich. Oh Allah, I want a child. And if you are sincere, and the conditions of dua are met, and there are no impediments, what are called mawani' al-dua, then you are guaranteed that Allah will respond. What will that response be? One of three things. Number one, you will get what you asked for. Number two, you will get something equivalent. Allah knows that's not good for you, so something equivalent that is good for you, you will get it. Or number three, a calamity that was destined for you is averted away. So you will get something for everything that you ask for. When the Sahaba heard this, they said, Ya Rasulullah, if that is the case, إِذَن نَسْتَكْثِرْ. We will ask for a lot. What prevents us from asking more and more and more? If every single dua, we will get something back, well then, we will ask more and more and more. إِذَن نَسْتَكْثِرْ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled and said, Allahu Akthar. Allah is much more than what you can ask for. Allahu Akthar. Allah is more than what you can ask for. So my dear brothers and sisters, never ever ever be stingy in your dua. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Abkhalu an-nas, the most stingy of people, man bakhila an ad-du'a, who's too stingy to make dua. Make dua for each and everything. Ask Allah and continue to ask Allah, and never be stingy to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of our scholars of the past said, the son of Adam, the more you ask him, the more irritated he gets with you. But Allah, the more you ask him, the more he loves you. The son of Adam, the more you ask, the more he'll want nothing to do with you. Even your best friend, how much can you ask from him before he'll get tired? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you ask, the more he will love you. And I conclude with this famous quote of Aisha radiallahu anha, that our mother and the most beloved wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she said, if your shoelace breaks, make dua that Allah gives you a new shoelace. Because unless Allah has willed it, you won't get a new shoelace. The point of this is, never trivialize your dua. If your shoelace breaks, you don't have a shoelace, make dua, oh Allah, give me another one. That is not trivial in the eyes of Allah. You are showing Allah, you are the abd and he is the rab. You are showing Allah, you need everything. So ask, and ask Allah, and ask Allah for all of your needs. And ask the big needs and the small needs. And ask the needs of the akhirah and the needs of this dunya. And continue to ask Allah. The more you ask Allah, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you.